Chip your pad thinking someday maybe you'll get that phone call in a worst case scenario.
But tonight, a Valley Animal Rescue Group is expressing outrage, saying that did not happen in the case of Bubbles.
The dog had a microchip, the dog had a tag on the collar, and the dog had a tag on the harness.
Both Al Bonin and Bubbles were hit and killed by a car last week near 19th Avenue and Bell. And now the dog they loved has ended up in a city dump, and they claim they never got the call about her.
ABC 15 Sonowasu looking into these concerns and goes to the vet clinic for answers.
I was the first person to see them on the streets, and the only thing the man asked me was for a bottle of water for his dog.
Friends say Al Bonin fell down on his luck and was trying to get back on his feet after the death of his wife and health problems. His only companion, this puppy, Bubbles, co-owned by Al and Dusty Lee with the rescue group Passionate People for Paws.
She was microchipped to me and only me.
Microchipped because it's the only way to identify who an animal belongs to when it's lost, injured, or in this case, killed. Dusty Lee says her group is a big advocate of it.
I'm known as the tag hag in the state of Arizona. And the reason I'm known as the tag hag is because I don't just believe in a microchip. I believe animals should have a tag on their collar as well as their harness.
So in this case, even after doing everything by the book, she wants to know why she did not get the phone call from the First Pet Veterinary Clinic in North Phoenix, a place that also strongly supports microchipping. We reached out to the clinic for a comment. A hospital manager says they did scan the deceased dog. While it is their practice to contact the owner and confirm final wishes, they were under the impression that the owner of the pet was deceased and did not make any other contacts. Lawyers we spoke to say while what the clinic did is within the law,
I don't think there's any liability, either criminal or civil. I think the public opinion, though, clearly you ask anybody, they say that that vet should have called the owner.
For this group who loved both Bubbles and Al, it's just added grief knowing this pup won't get the burial they feel she deserves. In North Phoenix, Sonowasu, ABC 15, Arizona.
Well, you sure hope that that doesn't happen if your dog gets lost.
Oh, yeah. Certainly. And I think that she brought up a really good point. You know, not only getting the microchip, but also having the address on their collar or phone number or something so that it makes it very easy. If your dog ever gets out, someone will know exactly who to contact.